and now, okay, some positions of solids. We have seen that terminologies in different ideas. See, in projection of planes, what I did, I gave you some, I think, six positions. Is it right? Yeah, six positions. I told if a question is given, if it is inclined or parallel or perpendicular to a plane, what would be the front view and what would be the top view. If that imagination is clear in your views, you will be obviously perfectly drawing the first front and first top views. Is it clear? And remember, I told you, you will get a minimum of 10 marks, sometimes till 12 marks, just for that first front and top views. This is the idea I gave for planes. And same thing in solids, like different sketches here. You see, I have now three steps I have. Positions of solids is first one. Step 1, what is the condition? Step 2, what is the condition? And step 3, if required. If not, finally, illustration. What is illustration? How does a solid look like based on these conditions? So I have drawn a sketch here. Is that okay? Now, this is clear. Now you see, axis perpendicular to HP and parallel to VP. I'll take any one solid. I'll take this solid. What is this actually? It is a square prism. You remember what is prism means? Prism means both sides should have same. It will be prism. Rectangle means both bottom and top will be rectangle, joined by edges. That's all. Now this is a square prism. Now axis perpendicular to HP and parallel to VP. What is axis? Where is the axis here? Axis comes in the center. Okay. This axis should be, condition is, perpendicular to HP. How does we make perpendicular to HP now? Is it correct? Shall I be a little more clear? I'll take another chalk piece. See, this should be your axis. Okay, it comes like this. This should be perpendicular to HP. Is it correct? If we make it like this, what will happen? This becomes axis perpendicular to VP. This is the VP. So, this is the current position. Axis perpendicular to HP and parallel to V. Obviously, when you keep an axis perpendicular to HP, means obviously it has to be parallel to VP. Okay, this is the condition. At this condition, when the position of the solid is like this, this is a solid, it has got an axis. If this axis is kept perpendicular to HP and parallel to VP, what is step 1? This is a basic criteria to be fulfilled. Only then you get an answer like this, say for example. And it is sure that if this is the condition, this will be the answer. See, I have drawn a pentagon sketch here. Maybe hexagon or square, whatever it is. But the purpose is, it has to be fulfilled. I will show a pentagon instead of this. I will show a pentagon. I have a pentagon here. It will be still more easier for you. This is the pentagon, right? Now this is the shape will be like this. See? Like this. Okay, actually I should not keep it like this. It is actually shape is like this. This is the base. It has been in the paper, it is tilted like this. In the top view, it is a pentagon. In the front view, you are looking at different lines. Okay, now here, what is the first step here? Draw the plan. Plan. First bracket, true shape of the base. If the axis, pentagon's axis, is perpendicular to HP, perpendicular to HP and parallel to VP, you have to, first step, draw the plan. What is the plan? I told you, plan means, what is the plan means? Draw the plan or true shape of the base. Plan means what? Top view. Plan means top view. Always plan is top view and front view is elevation. FV is known as elevation, other name. Elevation is called your front view. Is this okay? Plan means top view, front view means elevation. Now in this plan, draw the plan. It is plan first. Where is the plan now here? Plan means top view. Is this the top view? Is it true shape is this? Bracket shows true shape of the base. Draw the plan. Plan is this or true shape. I'll write. This is plan. True shape of the base. Any solid's base which is true shape can be drawn only in plan. That is all. Sorry. I mean to say plan means top view. Okay. Plan is top view. If its axis is perpendicular to HP and parallel to VP. This is the condition for any question. If you find that axis perpendicular to HP means you have to draw the original shape only in the top view or otherwise name is called plan. That's it. First step. Second step, then project the elevation. What is elevation I told? Elevation means front view. Project the elevation from it. That means I draw this, I will give point 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, etc. Okay? Just project it top. Plus. And this is your axis point. Actually, this shape is how I told you. Actually, it is like this. It means it is kept like this. It's the top view. We are rotating, no? Your X and this is VP and XP. It is like this shape. We are rotated like this. That means it is being rotated come like this. In your shape, you can write like this. Top view is this only. Exact pentagon is drawn in the top view. Front view is this. You see point number. I'll hold it properly because it's a paper. No, it is just, I cannot keep it very stiff. 1, 2, 3, 4 point. 1, 2, 3, 4 point. What is the center point means? You have read in. The dotted line means its axis. Axis is actually in the center. It is imaginary. You cannot see that. Any side. This is the red. That's it. That is for first condition. Now, axis perpendicular to VP. Second one. And parallel to HP. Opposite to this. How will I keep it? So, I can take same pentagon. Keep it like this. Pentagon is like this. Where is the axis? Like this. Perpendicular to VP. How do I make perpendicular axis? Now it is perpendicular to VP or HP? It is to HP. Bring it like this. Now this is the pentagon. Axis is going from the center. Perpendicular to VP. This is okay. And I don't think you need any explanation for this. Your front view is original true shape. And top view will be projected view. That's it. Then what will happen here? Draw the elevation. Elevation means, again, front view. Elevation, that is true shape of the base. Draw the elevation first. That means, elevation is this. Front view is the true shape. True shape. First. Then, remaining, then project the plan from it. This is the plan. We are projecting it from the top. That's clear? No. Then, what is this one? Last step. The third point in this positioning. Axis parallel to both HP and VP. How do I keep it parallel both HP and VP? This is the axis. See, I rotate like this. Say for example. Pentagon is this. Kindly see that. Axis is like this. I should make it parallel to both. Axis is made parallel to both HP and VP. Is the axis parallel to this? Both for HP and VP? Like this. Now in this shape, what will you see? See, I have drawn three sketches. I need not go for again explanation because you have already understood what is this. See, what is this? What view is this? Where is your true shape? From this side. Actually, it is like this. Axis is like this. Keep it like this. Why? I have to satisfy the condition. The axis is parallel for both VP and HP. VP and HP. So when after in this condition, from a front view I see, I am drawing it here. I see this line, I see bottom line, I see the top line. I see this line top, this line, and back is this. Front view, oh, this is, then this is top view. Why top view, they have two dotted lines, front top when I see, actually the shape is like this, okay. I can see this line, fine, in this line. And then, Next line is hidden. This is hidden, one dotted. Another line is hidden, because from top I see, you can hold it like in this, in your this position. You can see 1, 2 and 3, plus these two are hidden. I see one line this corner. Last line is this corner. Center actually it can be filled also. Nothing wrong. You can make it. And these two are your dotted lines. Center, even if you write a center line, nothing wrong, because the center point also is increased. But what is this view then? Whatever you see from this side, that means from your side, it is right hand side, you will be drawing it on left of the paper. It is called actually right side view. Right side view. Can you get me? From right hand side you see, whatever you see, you have to draw it in the left. In this paper, drawing sheet. But say for example, you are looking from here, if your eyes are here, you are standing here, you have to draw it in the opposite side. That's it. So very simple here, axis parallel to both HP and VP, draw, first step, draw the side view first. That means the side view is the one which can show you the true shape of the body. A pentagon, exact five sides are shown only in the side view. How will we draw the projected views without knowing the values? Obviously, I should have maybe it is 40 millimeter, 60 millimeter side. So I can make it a pentagon using your normal procedures of making a pentagon that you have already learned. This one you make it. Then you go for side views. What is the side view? Project the elevation. Elevation means again, what is elevation? Front view. Elevation and plan, it is top view. From that, from here, I am projecting this and this also. That is okay. That's fine. This is the steps, positions of solids. Some more steps also there, right? Okay. And now we have seen previously some three positions, right? Now this is fourth, fifth, and sixth positions. I once again repeat, these six. I can say illustrations or positions of solids, if you are able to understand clearly, you can draw any sketch in projection of solids, that is unit number 3. Kindly understand, I am talking about now unit number 3, U3. Okay? This already I finished 3, this is the 3rd and 4th, and 4, 5 and 6. Now what is the next one here? Axis is inclined to VP and parallel to HP. How do I make it? Again, I will take a pentagon itself. Pentagon will have an axis like this. Suppose it is inclined to VP. Where is VP? This is VP. And parallel to HP. How first I will set it parallel to HP? I will just have an axis here. Suppose this pentagon, anything it is, it looks like this. This is axis. Okay. The pentagon axis is inclined to be parallel to HP. Is this parallel to HP now? Yeah. And inclined to VP. How to show the VP inclination? Here, this axis will be, inclination is VP like this. Kindly remember, if you lift it like this, it becomes inclined to HP. Okay? And if it is inclined to VP, it should lift it like this. So, in the top view, you can see the inclination. In the front view, it will be the original shape. That's what we learned. Okay, now, axis is inclined to VP and parallel to HP. Here, draw the elevation first. What is elevation again? Elevation front view. Draw the front view of pentagon as it is. First, with axis perpendicular to VP. See, axis inclined to VP. Wherever it is inclined, you just made that is perpendicular to VP and draw the front view. Good. Then, and project the plan. Just you made it exactly the front view and projecting it to the plan and becomes the top view. The top you can see this four lines, 1, 2, 3 and 4. You have dotted lines here, 1, 2, 3, 4. This you can see, this also. See, please make, I already interested you, kindly make this type of shapes. You cut a paper, either a chart paper or something like that. Hold it in your hand with your VP and HP. Just open your notebook in that any, just like this patient like this, VP and HP. Keep it in your firm, hold it from your right hand and then look into that. See, from the front side, it's a front view. And you have to imagine that you are an observer, you look from the top, and the top side you are drawing. Okay, now front side is like this. Is it clear? Sketches like this. And from the top, what can I see? I'll see first line is this, this second line, it becomes this second line. Third, this is actually invisible, this. Then this is also invisible here, and this line, this one. Over. Again, remember these two alone carries 10 marks, which I already told you. First front view, proper placement of first front view and first top view will get 10 marks. Then inclination point. Then what is that here? Redraw the plan. What is plan here? Front view. I'm sorry, plan means elevation. I mean, plan is top view. Redraw the plan with the required inclination with XY line. What is the inclination required here? Axis is inclined to VP. Obviously, it should be like this because this is your HP. This is your VP. Okay? HP and VP. So, I've already told anything which is inclined to HP can be drawn on VP, and anything which is inclined to VP can be drawn on HP. That's all. Now, it is where inclined to VP it is. It will be drawn on HP only. That concept is very basic from the lines we have started. You should not forget. That's it. Now, this sketch as it is, I am redrawing. That means making it what? The axis is inclined to VP. See, this center point is axis. Actually, it like this. So, this makes an angle of, say, suppose some degree. And kindly remember I told the inclination with respect to VP, we take it as theta or phi. Yeah, it's phi. You remember, very good. It is phi. Maybe 30 or 40 degrees. Inclination to HP will be theta. That symbol you don't forget. It is theta for HP and phi for VP. Okay? That is basic. Now, so first step, drawing elevation first with the axis perpendicular to VP and project it to the plan. This is over. Second step, redraw the plan. That means as such you tilt it and make the center line as such with the given angle. From this, if it is whatever the 30 or 40, whatever the length, you just make it. Finish the firearm. Then, what is the last one? Step 3, project the line elevation. What is this? This you bring it. All this you bring it to the top. It becomes this shape. Okay, you can better make it in your drawing sheet, because in the board, I'm not drawing anything in specific dimensions. Very important. You can better make it, because the final shape will be looking like this. You need not worry about this final shape, this. But when you make it, it will come. See, in this final shape, it is given all these are thick lines and only one dotted line. Because if this is the shape, it is actually, if after this shape, it is top view, and this condition is something like this. Somewhere like this, because you can see one pentagon has the opposite side of the other pentagon. It's a mix of two pentagons. Whichever is invisible, you are putting in dotted line. But when you give number of points and bring it, you know, you will understand which is invisible. That one, that line alone, you make it dotted. That's it. Okay. See, the idea is to say that when you find a question that axis is inclined to VP and parallel to HP means, you should first see that you are drawing the elevation first. That means what is elevation? Front view. Front view. This is elevation. This is front view. Elevation or elevation. This front view first by making the axis perpendicular to VP and projecting to the top view. Then go for inclinations. Now, the second first answer is over. This you understood. The second point is, now what happened here? Axis is inclined to HP and parallel to VP. Now, what I am making it now? I should see that axis is inclined to HP and parallel to VP. VP is here. I should make it parallel. See, this is the axis of this pentagon. It is axis is like this. Axis is going like this. I should make it parallel to VP. Parallel to VP first. And inclined to HP. How will I make it inclined to HP? HP is here. Inclination, it should be like this. Clear? It is like this means inclination to be this. If I make inclination like this, it will be to VP inclination, where you give from the top view. Our basics, we do not forget. Basics is same. So, it like this. This is the axis. It is parallel to this, by inclined to parallel to VP, made parallel to VP, and inclined to HP. Now inclined to HP, I am making like this. So this is the condition. Now here, what can I see? Draw the plan first. What do plan means? Top view. Plan first with axis perpendicular to HP. If the axis is inclined to a plane, that one we should make it perpendicular and draw it in the plan. See, from this you should arrive to a conclusion that, see, first point, if the axis is inclined to HP means we are making to which plane it is inclined, to that plane we make it perpendicular, because the opposite plane will be parallel for that. See, very simple, HP and VP are 90 degree apart, perpendicular to each other, that's it. So axis is inclined to HP, parallel to VP, inclined to HP, it is inclined to HP means obviously it should be perpendicular to HP. So draw the plan first with axis perpendicular to HP and project the elevation. You are drawing the plan in the top view, it is like this. This is the condition actually, you are twisting it like this, rotating it, top view look like this, and front view is this. This is the paper, we are tilting it. This is the condition, top view is a true shape. From top view you see, it will be like this, this is a true shape, and projecting it to the top. Okay, then redraw the elevation with the required inclination. Elevation, required inclination. What is elevation here? This is your plan, this is elevation. This one you are redrawing with inclination angle. What is inclination angle here? Axis is inclined to HP. So inclination to HP will be always drawn on VP. Already told. So this basics, this inclination is in VP only you are drawing inclination to HP. This angle is that given angle. That's all. This will be what? Phi or theta? It is theta. That angle. Then you project it down, everything down. This also you project it, you will make the final sketch. Is clear? Then what is the final one? Axis is inclined to both VP and HP. This is the final one. How will I make it? This is one parallel to both HP and VP. If I make it this inclination, inclination to HP, this side inclination to VP, I should make both, it is this side as well as this side in this condition. This is the condition. How do I make both the clear? Now here axis is inclined to both VP and HP. Now what to write? Draw the plan with axis perpendicular to HP. When the axis is inclined to both HP and VP means, you make the axis of the body, solid, perpendicular to HP. First, it's the first condition. If you want to make the axis perpendicular to HP means, which condition is here? Second condition. So obviously, the axis is perpendicular to HP means, first point you have to think, the true shape will come in the top view. Is it okay? So the true shape normally you will write in the top view. Project it, you will get the front view. So obviously when you project it top, front view, that will be redrawing the elevation. The same condition of this, you make it, bring it down. So first inclination is taken, you have drawn it. Then redraw the projected plan to give inclination to XY. That means after getting this sketch, first is this, this is 2, this is 3, this is 4. After this, this one you have to redraw it to what angle wanted? Another angle. That is, you are making incline to other one. Inclination, incline to project the plan. Other say suppose it is 30 degree to VP and 45 degree to HP. First you are making it with respect to HP first. That's why you are drawing it on VP. Then you are making the next angle with respect to VP and finishing at the final. That's all. Okay. So these steps, if you have it perfectly, if you remember all these steps by practicing, any diagram in solids can be drawn perfectly, right?